Hey folks, this is Best in Slot and welcome to the final build in our aquatic park. In the past five episodes we've brought in all five of the aquatic DLC animals, but we had a little bit of room left and I thought, okay, we'll add the saltwater crocodile, which has also been given the deep diving mechanic that was added with the latest patch. The only one of the older animals to have it so far, but others will be getting it in the future. Now, this was the longest build so far. This was actually just over 4 hours this took. Now, I had some problems with the game crashing, etc., but this was a long old build. And for reasons you'll see why very shortly. We're going to try to build a little hut here. I ended up scrapping it because I can't build buildings, so I went and got some inspiration from someone else. So big credit to Pickle Pringle, who uploaded this really nice hut onto the workshop, which I used as a base, basically. I didn't like use the entire thing. As you can see, I'm building it myself, but the kind of general formation. And this is not like it's particularly complicated or anything. I'm not good with buildings. This is why I don't do buildings. Even a simple hut, I was here for like half an hour trying to build one and getting really annoyed. So yeah, credit to them for that. We're going to talk more about the hut later on. We're just kind of building it now. It's meant to look dilapidated, a little bit run down, falling apart, stuff like that. A little bit inspired initially by Lake Placid. This is a crocodile habitat. And Lake Placid is a phenomenal, in my opinion, it's one of my favourite films, comedy horror film about a man-eating crocodile, basically. It's really, really good. Watch it if you haven't already. It's a classic. But there's an old woman in Lake Placid who feeds the baby crocodiles, and that's how they end up like surviving and growing up super big and stuff like that. So the little hut kind of in the swamp was a little bit inspired by that. The other thing we're going to do, however, is why this build took such a very, very long time. We're going to do something I've literally never done before, and that is to build an underwater tunnel. You know, like you go to an aquarium and you go for a shark tunnel and there's glass above you and the water's above you and you can see the sharks swimming over your head. We're going to do that same thing, but in Planet Zoo, which it does actually work. It's phenomenal. It's really cool. It's just a lot of hard work to get it to work. Credit to 8-Bit Josh. I'm going to link their YouTube channel down below. They have a tutorial on how to do this. I would not have known how to do it. I'll try to explain it as we do it in the video, but I would have had no idea without that video, so big shout out to them. Yep, just testing the water levels. So basically, you can see it's worked already. There's the path, there's the water. It's actually pretty simple. All you're doing is filling an area with water and then tunneling a path underneath it using the tunnel button. And you have to kind of make it so that when you straighten the path out, it's just under the level of the water, basically. When you mess around with it in person, you do kind of get the hang of it eventually. I say that after 4 hours, I finally got the hang of it. But back to this for now. Just building like a little fence, I'm just building a hut, basically. I don't know what else to tell you. So like I say, originally it was inspired by Lake Placid. That's gonna change by the end, but we'll talk about that when we get there. Basically, I found an image on Pinterest, which I will try to remember to link this time. But I found an image on Pinterest which inspired me, shall we say, so we'll get to that later. Just putting some damage in the roof, you know, lift some logs up, rotate them around a little bit, just so it looks a little bit like it's fallen down a little bit more than it had. It's still a little bit neat and tidy, but that's alright. Got a little fence, same thing with the fence, you know, rotate it here and there. She's kind of patched up the roof of whatever was lying about, whatever she could find in the swamp at this point. You know, some old sheet metal, some, you know, old pieces of wood kind of stuck together, blah, 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 blah. Just keeping the house together. It's not like an important building to her, is the vibe. I could not make my mind up about the window. It does end up staying in, question mark, does it? Maybe it doesn't, I might get rid of it. Building a little door frame and a little door out of sheet metal, because why not, basically. This is like how I spent most of my time at the start of this thing, is just working on this. These are the new things as part of the aquatic pack that you are actually meant to put them onto roofs, essentially. That is the idea. But you can put them on the ground and stuff like that as well, but they're just squares of plant life that sink really well into a building and they look really nice. So we're going to use those to just give everything a swampy, mossy, overgrown kind of feel to it. Same with the ivy. I went mental on the plants with this one. I've had to restrain myself lately, so I went a little bit crazy. This is a really, really big area, and there are very few plants in Planet Zoo that have a swampy kind of feel to them, so I had to use the same ones over and over and over again. It didn't look great to me until like the very end. It came together really, really close to the end, so don't panic, folks. All right, that's all I'm saying, don't panic. But anyways, the idea is you'll walk through. You're not going to have like an overground viewing area. You will just observe the whole thing from within the water. You can't even see the hut from the water, so technically you don't really experience the hut at all, but it's for us, you know? And you'll go through a tunnel, and you'll just walk along the base of this swamp and come out on the other end, and that's where the penguin habitat is, and we go from there. Loads and loads and loads of these weeping willows, and as people mentioned, Pocahontas, not... What film did I say? I can't remember. I said it wasn't Pocahontas what I said. Anyways, it's Pocahontas, where she talks to the weeping willow. And we're going to use tons of those, because it's the only swampy plant. The fig has a little bit of that vibe to it, but really the willow is the only one that's got a proper swamp feeling to it. We need a swamp pack. That's what I want next. We've had the aquatic pack. Let's have a swampy pack. That'd be really cool. There'd be some great animals we can get in there as well. Anyways, so there's a lot of these. it's a very, very large area, and you notice at this point I haven't even put the barrier in at this point in time because I wasn't sure how big the enclosure was going to be. I wasn't sure how it was going to work out. It was a little bit up in the air, this one, and I was getting really annoyed about the crashes. 5 or 6 times it crashed whilst I was doing this. I kept losing like little bits. I never lost too much because I became really paranoid and kept saving it, but anyways. I decided that should be more like a little pier, so, you know, have that stick out. Not by much, you know, just a little jutting out area there. So it looks like a little, you know, little shack abandoned in the swamp. That's really just all I wanted, and I think it kind of works. I think that's what it looks like. Gotta keep testing the water levels for this kind of thing. It's all about the water levels for this, which is cool because that's kind of what the whole vibe has been throughout this entire playthrough. So it's good that we got to do that one more time. Now, as a warning, my game has broken. I don't know if it's because of the path. I don't know if it's because I've just got so much stuff in like a really small area in this zoo. This is not a big zoo, but it is crammed with thousands of rocks, thousands of trees. But when I hit play, when it's paused, it's fine. But when I hit play, the game goes, it just inches forward. It's really, really annoying. I'm a little worried that my tour is going to have to be in pause mode. And what I'm probably going to do is kill the water in this area and see if that fixes it. And what we'll do is we'll do a normal speed tour with no water in here. And then when we get around here, we'll do a paused tour with the water in. I don't know what else to do at this point. I'm hoping when I log back on in a minute for the second part of this video that it's working. But yeah, I'm a little nervous. I'm not going to lie. I tried to not go too hard on the rocks. I ended up putting a lot more in. Because it's a swamp, and swamps don't feel particularly rocky to me. But I figured they could have like rocks sort of embedded into the ground. I wanted a little archway, because again, arches to me are spooky for some reason. I don't know what that's about, but arches have a slightly cultist, satanic, Wiccan, not that I'm associating Satanism and Wiccanism together, don't get me wrong. My mother's a Wiccan, my sister's a Wiccan. Not that there's anything wrong with Satanism either, by the way. Satanism gets a bad rap. You'll see the water's really murky here, because I really like how it looks. Having that murky swamp water. The problem is, you just can't see a bloody thing. it just ruins it, unfortunately. So, had to give up on that dream in the end. But we'll do that again in the future. It's a nice idea. Here, I was just trying to get the water level perfect more than anything else. You can see how the sides of this are really high up. Now, you can get it so that the floor and the path are basically even. You'd have to do a lot of trial and error. And I didn't really realize you could do that till afterwards when I went back and checked the video. But the side is too high for me, and the path is also too big. So I spent a solid half an hour to an hour here just redoing the path, redoing the water. It is a finicky process. To get perfect, this is really annoying. It ends up looking really, really cool, don't get me wrong, and it is worth it. But if you want to do this at home, be prepared to put the time in, basically. So here I am. I'm trying to change you can see the ground there got raised up a little bit, or placed down a little bit. I'm just trying to adjust it so that when we put the path in, there's room at the side, though there's like a gap at the side, but it's not too big, so there's a little bit more leeway. And unfortunately, I kind of went crazy with the flatten brush, and I ruined so much of my terrain work that I'd done, but what are you going to do? Frontier, if you're watching, swamp pack, people would love it. Although, what animals would you have in the swamp pack? Let me know your suggestions. Anyways, you can see there, the side is a lot smaller this time, but it's working out pretty well. A lot smaller, so lots more room. Clearly wasn't perfect. And there we have crash number one. Prepare for several more. So I didn't lose much on any of these. As I say, I became very, very paranoid with the saving to make sure that never really happened anymore. Just using a little... It felt like if I used a really wide path, it took up too much of the habitat, and it didn't feel enclosed in the way that I wanted. But also the problem was we're using this curved, actually using the same thing that Josh uses in their video, although they didn't realise. It's like this curved piece of glass. It's like a classical piece in Planet Zoo. And we use that to form the tunnel itself. And it only fits over the smallest path. This is the 4-wide path, and that's the one that it fits over. Had to bring the rocks in just because we've got this really annoying curb that you can't get rid of because this counts as an elevated path. The curb is there by default. So I figured, okay, I don't want tons of rocks, but tons of rocks are better than a curb, basically, because the curb just looks bizarre. And there you go, there is the tunnel. Now, if you want to do this in a really neat way, you should have a straight path because that's going to look better. You're not going to have this weird crossover that I've got here and there. However, I wanted it to be curvy. I thought that was cooler. And I thought having the metal overlap every now and again in the tunnel was a better idea. But you can see what this is called. This is a classic arbor arch. So use that and yeah, look at it. It's like an underwater tunnel. It's really cool. I'm blown away that this works. Clearly it's not meant to. The game hates it. It crashed constantly, although it's been doing that even before I did this, admittedly. And there's me saving again. Kept crashing and now it's gone into slowdown mode. Finally adding the barrier. I was a little apprehensive about this. Although maybe this is when it started to slow down, when I brought the crocs in. Anyways, this took a little work as well, trying to make an entrance area for the crocodiles, so a way for the crocodiles to get in and out of the habitat. We've got this, nicely, it links up, that's the penguin entrance over there, by the way, so it links up really nicely with that, kind of, at the back. Well, not good. Pointing in the feeders, because as people mentioned in the caiman habitat, I did notice, but I cut it out of the video, but basically the feeders have to be at a certain depth. I just wanted to make sure that they were at the right depth because they have to sit on a little rock so that you can see them correctly, but we had to make sure they weren't so high up that they weren't functioning. Now, I keep trying to use these steps and I tell you what, the animals bloody hate them. Okay, so we should talk about what's going on here. I saw this image on Pinterest and it was like this old overgrown shack in the woods that was glowing yellow out into this like boardwalk area, and then it was all swampy and it was really, really cool looking. And the idea being, you know, some magic has been cast in there, there's spells or there's potions or whatever, there's a witch in there basically doing witchy things, and it just inspired me basically, so that's what I went on. So no longer is it Lake Placid, it's now, you know, it's an old like swamp hag living in the swamps and casting her swampy spells. And there's crash number two. Three more to go. They get quicker at this point. But anyways, the idea was, you know, swamp witch hag kind of thing. Not to, again, not hating on witches or Wiccans or, you know, it's not my kind of thing, but I have a lot of family members who are into that malarkey, so not hating, but it's a classic thing. Swamp hag. So that's what we're going with. It inspired me. I don't know what it's got to do with saltwater crocodiles, but. And there's number three. So she can feed the crocodiles. She can be the woman from Lake Placid, but also a witch at the same time. The next crash is coming in soon because I put all these rocks in and then I lose them. So any second now. Well, maybe not. Putting in some, I'm really going quite light on the decoration stuff down here. In the actual tunnel. Now we need plant life. This is a swamp, it's a tropical swamp essentially. So it needs a lot of plant life. This eelgrass, I wasn't a big fan of initially, but when you have tons of it, it looks really cool. I really like how it looks when you've got tons of the stuff all gathered around. It looks a lot better. So if you want to make your plant life a little bit more interesting in your water with the aquatic pack, I would recommend the eelgrass for sure. Just put loads of it in, basically, and it ends up looking a lot better. I also did something someone recommended in the last video where the crack in the rock isn't black, but it's green, so it looks like there's moss kind of crawling in the cracks of the rocks a little bit. It's quite a subtle effect, but it looks pretty good. Crash number four. I think there's one more before the end. And I think it's pretty soon, because the end went pretty well, like everything's moved out at the very, very end. Getting the crocs in, just trying to, you know, get all this working. As you can see, they can't get in. I was getting that really weird slowdown problem, so here I was just trying to, like, refresh the level to see if it helped. And no, we didn't really, so once again, as with the seal habitat, we are turning to the bamboo. The bamboo is going to save the day. For some reason, animals love to climb on the bamboo more than anything else. So we're just going to use the bamboo, we're going to make a little ramp, staircase kind of thing, and as you can see with all that blue there, it finally works. We're also going to bring in quite a lot of crocodiles, just because, you know, it's quite a large exhibit, this. So I think I've got 12 of them in total. Really liked this. I did not know this was a thing until today, but when you change the colour Wait for it. Yeah, when you change... I'll just pause it for a sec. When you change the colour of the torches, the flame changes as well. It's like this... It reminds me of, like, fel magic or something. Or, like... I don't know, like, you know, evil witches in cartoons and stuff like that. They always cast a green flame. So that's kind of what I was going with. Really made me hype. This thing that looks awesome. I've become obsessed with lights, I'll admit. Doing what we always do, we're using the spotlights to light up the feeders. And also just smashing a few of them around as well, just so the whole area is a bit lit up. This was a big problem. I wanted... The tunnel needs lights, because otherwise you would die. People would just fall over constantly, right? People would not make it through alive. But the problem is, any of the big lights will also light up the glass, and they create reflections in the glass, and you can't see the crocodiles as easily. So my first plan was to use like spotlights or smaller spotlights to kind of shine the light down the tunnel basically, so that way I could aim it away from the glass and aim it at the floor. But it just ended up being really bright. And the solution ended up being these baubles. I just stick these in the side. They look kind of cute anyway. We put them in the side. They light up the floor really nicely in this warm orange yellowish light, but they don't shine much onto the glass. It's very subtle if they do. I'm going to end up doubling up on there as well. Anyway, so yeah, just putting all lights in at the moment. It was a little bit too much. I liked this look of like the green, flying up and lighting up the whole area. But as with the Cayman exhibit, when we had like spare moonlight, it kind of detracts from the power of the witch's shack basically. So we had to get rid of it so that the witch's shack glow. Maybe there's no more crash. I don't remember it crashing after here. Doing the busy work now. Obviously, we have to join our two habitats together. So that's what we're going to do. Everything is now finished, basically. Near enough 100% finished. Yeah, it's kind of crazy. I'm going to put some rocks to the side. I just don't like natural earth anymore. Like, I've gone off the ground entirely. And the rocks have been a theme, so why not? There were some problems. I mean, this links nicely in with the base of the tunnel as well, so I forgive myself. And they look like the mossy and stuff like that. It's pretty cool. I've still got the earth there at the roof as well, even as I cover half of it. Then I look at that. Gonna do that on both sides. So, take a look at my hut, my shack. Shacking up with my shack. Doing the same thing over here, just moving the rock around. Stacking it up. Really didn't need to use anything other than rock 3 for this one. Good old rock 3. It's not even my favourite rock, but it is the most useful rock, you know? Favourite things don't have to be the most useful. Just be the cools. I don't know what my coolest one is. Maybe rock 2. Rock 2 is pretty sweet. Gonna do a sign. A sign I've never used before. This is the New World sign. No, this is like, what is this? Yeah, editable arch. And it's alright. It's decent size. So this is Saltwater Swamp. Because what else was it going to be called, really? It's a swamp with salt waters. Hanging some... I really like how that looks as well. The what are they called again? Bloody Nora. Weeping Willows kind of hanging over the top of the sign. Put some water in, just kind of decorating the whole area now, just making it look a little bit nicer, bring it all together. And by the time this is done, the park is finished, folks. It is literally finished. As soon as it works again, and I can actually bloody move, then we'll be done. Little stuff only sign in there. And just need to make sure, this is a common thing, but just making sure you can't see the staff buildings, basically, because I don't want to see any of that nonsense. It's all about your sight lines, folks. All about your sight lines. Bringing in some plant life. Love these blue lotus lily pads. They look really nice. Big fan of those. I did try to stick to roughly the same plants. There's a lot of tropical plants that you could use in theory for the habitat, but a lot of them don't have a swampy kind of feel to them. Simple as that, basically. So I had a selection of about 4 or 5 plants that were tropical. There was a couple of aquatic ones as well, like the weeping willow, but they were basically tropical, but I felt like they would work in a swampy looking environment. This is gonna be our zoo entrance. Not putting any effort into this at all. It's an igloo because I don't wanna do buildings. The reason I've been so on board with this park and like getting involved and we've done it, you know, this is our 5th exhibit in a row. I took Sunday off because they always do, but it's been a lot of work this past week, but the reason I'm happy to do it is because I'm doing the things I like, basically. I'm going to stop pretending otherwise. I'm going to stop doing things I don't like because I'm, you know, envious of other YouTubers or I think it's more popular or anything like that. We're just going to do the stuff we like to do, basically, and it's worked out really well. Tomorrow we'll do a full tour. Like I say, it might be a little higgledy-piggledy. We'll see how it goes. Higgledy-piggledy, official word, by the way. I might take a couple days off after that. As I say, there is a reason other Planet Zoo YouTubers don't do a big build every single day, because it's a lot of work. It takes up a lot of time to do this kind of thing. you know, it's not just 4 hours for the build, it's everything else. But I might take a couple of days off to chill, and then we'll be back with other stuff. Obviously, we'll have regularly scheduled content. It's not just going to be Planet Zoo going forward, but I would like to keep on the Planet Zoo train in a slightly more chill way until the next DLC comes out and we'll go mental again. Doing one of my favourite things there, let me just skip to the end very quickly, which is to put spotlights right there to light up the sign, obviously, so Saltwater Swamp. But then, wait for it, to put them, inside the headlights of the car. You sink them in there, and it looks like the car's shining. It's a really cool effect. Remember, that's the car where the guy went spelunking in the Cayman Cove cave, cavern, whatever we end up calling it. Right, so I'm going to pray to the Swamp Witch that this has decided to work. Let's load it up in-game and give you a proper look. Right, folks, about 10 hours after I recorded the first part of this video, I can finally do this part. I mentioned in the video that I was having some problem with a lag. It was bad. It was 1 FPS. It was unbearable to play. I really wanted to get it to work, because otherwise the tour would be impossible when we do the tour tomorrow. And shout out to Rudy Renkamel, who is a really, really good Planet Zoo creator. He hit me up on Twitter when I asked about this, told me how to fix it. Basically, what I've done is cleared. I had guests in my park. I built like a little entrance over here, and I had guests in the park, and they were lagging the whole thing. So I cleared all the guests out. I cleared out lots of the caimans and stuff like that. And they're still there, but there's many less of them. Cleared all of those out. Did a fresh restart of the game. And it seems to have fixed it. It's on play and it's not breaking. So big shout out to Rudy, because otherwise this was doomed. So let's take a quick look at the habitat, because I need to get this bloody video uploaded. Right, already my crocs. Are you walking on the lily pad? Because that's nonsense, my friend. You are pooping on a lily pad. Wow, not sure how I feel about that one. There we go, look at that. Very cool. Right, we're going to try this out at nighttime as well. Shouldn't be able to see the... I can kind of get the bit of the glow. Yes! Oh, I love it. It's just catching the end of the glow from the feeder. It's like he's curious about it. Like he's hunting down the feeder. Look at him. What a baller. Da-da-da-da. That is what I wanted right there. The music kind of ruins it. It's a bit too happy and jaunty, but... Oh! What the hell did you just do? Stop sitting on the lily pad. Doesn't make sense. That is so good. That's all I wanted. That silhouette right above me is what I wanted. We can just pretend he's swimming right now. Anyway, so this is it at nighttime. Sorry, I've kind of recorded this video like 7 times. There's the tunnel. You can see the lights kind of chill a little bit. This is a bit annoying, but not really anything I can do about that, unfortunately. But yeah, it looks really nice at night, I think. All these lit up. They look a bit weird in the daytime, but at night it kind of comes together a little bit more. And I'll show you the actual water at nighttime as well. There you go. Have a little swim around. I say lots and lots of eelgrass. Some areas just lit up to make them look a little bit more interesting. That's what the tunnel looks like. It's like the... I don't know, it's like some sci-fi looking thing. Just kind of the inspiration for the lights. Where are you off to, eh? Nobody knows. And then the hut. The shack. The witch's shack. The hag. Shack, whatever you want to call it. The Swamp Shack. Sounds like a bizarre cafe. Like I said, I got rid of the lights in like several other places. They were much stronger on all these trees, but I wanted the shack to really like stand out, you know. It's really glowing on its own. Like the torch as well, but that's kind of part of the whole deal, you know? Yeah, I like it. Yeah, it's pretty cool. This has worked really well. This yeah, again, 8-bit Josh, good lad. I would not have had a clue otherwise. Technically we're underwater right now. Where are my crocs at? If I was a... Oh, hello. Stop walking on the lily pads. Where have you gone? Nah. There we go. What I'd like is like a proper walking around mode and you could have like a torch. I know that would be bad in the zoo. You shouldn't do that, but for this it'd be really handy. Why are my feeders not doing feedy things? Da-da-da-da. Da-da-da-da. I got to change these lily pads. I can't deal with this. This is nonsense. Still haven't seen the feeder activate. That's really the thing I'm holding out for at this point. But many more crocs now. I brought them all into this main area, and hopefully they're all doing okay. Where are you off to? Look at that colouring though, the black and the green and the yellow and the wetness. It's all my favourite things. Make sure that you can get out there, yeah? There we go. That's why this area is lit. Oh, and over there as well. Oh, they look so good. Hey guys. The feeder is not getting filled. It's one of the problems. A little shimmy shake. What is this? Oh, it looks so good. Oh, we're feeder. Yeah. Okay, cool. Right, now don't pause, numpty. Okay, now we wait and we watch. So this is what it would be like if you were walking around the habitat. See what I mean? The light's kind of getting away, but not really. You can't have no lights. People would die. They'd just fall over. Yes, baby! Yes! Nom, nom, nom! Someone else coming. Oh, it's spooky. It's exactly what I wanted. Spooky, but in the daytime it actually looks, you know, quite pleasant. It's just like a nice little swampy area. But at nighttime, with the green light and the darkness and the you know, crocodiles, it has that slight horror aesthetic that, as you know, I'm slightly obsessed with. Is that going as well? Yeah. Did you numb? I think they're mainly gonna hang out with this one, so I'm gonna stay here. It's a nice shot there, isn't it? It's a nice shot. Where you off to? Doing your thing? I'll let you do your thing. I just wanna see if someone else come and feed. Oh, back to the tunnel. This is what I live for. This is why the tunnel exists, for moments exactly like that. Where all you can see is the shadow. Well, it's not. It is them, but they appear cloaked within the shadow. Ooh, hello. You're getting very spicy. It's like it's about to go for an attack. Yeah, really happy with it. About to nom. Oh, nom 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 nom. Let's hop back into daytime just for a second because I know I kind of skipped it. I've been trying to put this video together for a very, very long time. Oh, you can really see them well at daytime, actually. I wasn't sure how visible they'd be, but yeah, very good. Oh, look at it! Look at it! Meow. Swimming under the other croc as well. Awesome. Hello, crocodiles. Yeah, there you go, folks. That is Saltwater Swamp. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Please do hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. Tomorrow, we will be back with a tour. We're going to go through all 6 habitats, one by one by one by one, and just experience it as a guest, both at daytime and at nighttime. You see what I mean? This is quite a nice, pleasant area at daytime, and then, you know, dun-dun-dum, and it just, the tone just changes immediately. I like that. Yeah. So, had a lot of fun with this whole series. We're going to do the tour tomorrow, then I'm probably going to take a couple days off. This is hard work, this kind of stuff. But, yeah, really excited to do the full thing tomorrow. Stick around for that. Check out the playlist down below. Please do hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers much, as always. Bye-bye.